Welcome, welcome everyone to our show, Christmas Unmasked. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I am so excited to be your host this week. We are going to unmask the real meaning of Christmas along with celebrating Jesus with some awesome singers, and some are not very awesome, but we're glad to have them. You're gonna vote on your favorite, but before we get to that, let's do our own singing and dancing as we worship Jesus together. Jump to your feet.
You will be my strength. When my mind says I
introducing our judges once again, we have the lovely Miss Rebecca. And last but not least, we have last year's champion, Miss Emily. We want to know who's on this week, and we're going to go right into our competition. Check out our first competitor. And now let's hear it for Cindy Lunicorn.
Hi, everybody. My name's Cindy Lunicorn. One of the things that I do really well is organize. Organization is my strength. I knew I wasn't going to get eliminated last week. I'm probably not going to get eliminated this week.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing are bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time, it's a swell time to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the Jingle Bell Rock.
Oh, I am totally in the dancing spirit now. Let's hear it for that competitor. Woo! And check out who's up next. All right, up next, Mr. Claus.
Guys, Mr. Claus is back. I told you I'm gonna win, clawing my way up to the top. My favorite part of Christmas is the decorations and family. My favorite thing to do for fun is go fast. And my favorite person is definitely Pastor Paula. She didn't pay me to say that, but really it's my grandparents.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight.
All right, well now, here to perform our memory verse, Miss Sasha.
Stop! No, don't stop. Oh, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here today. Are you standing up? Are you on your feet? Because we're about to do this memory verse together, guys. All right, it is found in Isaiah 9, 5 through 7. A child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, and all authority will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, and Prince of Peace. One more time, just a little bit slower, guys. Isaiah 9, 5 through 7. A child is born to us. A son is given to us, and all authority will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, and Prince of Peace. All right, guys, keep practicing.
Next up, Piggy Smalls.
Deck the halls, it's Piggy Smalls again. Are you guys excited to see me? Thank you, thank you. My favorite thing to do during Christmas is rap. My favorite thing to do for fun is eat. Duh, I'm a pig. And my favorite person, besides Jesus, has to be my mama. We love you, mama.
Deck the halls, it's Piggy Smalls. Fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly. Fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel. Fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol. Fa la 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 la. Fa la 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 la. Fa la 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 la. Fa la 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 la. Fa la 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 la. See the blazing Yule before us. Fa la 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 la. Strike the harp and join the chorus. Fa la 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 la. Follow me to merry measures. Fa la 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 la. Why I tell the Yuletide treasure. Fa la la.
I am so excited about all this singing and dancing. After all, we are celebrating Jesus the whole month of December, the same way we should be celebrating him every day of our lives. The real meaning of Christmas is celebrating Jesus. So let's go into the second part of the story of Jesus.
The story of Christmas, Jesus and the wise men. This is Jesus.
Hoo-yah!
Jesus is the Son of God who would grow up to do amazing things. His parents on earth were Mary
Hi.
And Joseph.
Hey-o.
Jesus was born in a barn because there was no room for him anywhere else in Bethlehem. Bethlehem was part of Judea, an area that was ruled by a king named Herod. King Herod was in Jerusalem when some wise men from eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem asking,
Excuse me.
Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star as it rose and we have come to worship him. When Herod heard that there was another king born in Judea, he was very upset. As was everyone else in Jerusalem.
Yeah, not you.
So Herod called all the important priests and Jews together and asked them where this king was supposed to be born. The Jews knew that their king would eventually come, and it was always told to them that the king of the Jews, the savior of the world, would be born in Bethlehem. So they told that to King Herod. Then King Herod thought of a way to trick the wise men. So he called a private meeting with them and learned from them when the king of the Jews' star first appeared.
Oh, good!
And then King Herod told the wise men, go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me so that I can go and worship him too.
Okay.
Hey, on your way.
But secretly, Herod wanted to know where the king of the Jews was so he could get rid of him. So the wise men went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where Jesus was, and the wise men were filled with joy.
Woohoo!
They went into the house and saw Mary and Jesus.
Hello!
Oh, look! Wow!
And they bowed down and worshiped Jesus.
Wait!
They gave him special gifts fit for the king that he was, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then God warned them in a dream to not go home through Jerusalem, where King Herod was, but God told them to go home a different way. So they did. And then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up." The angel told Joseph to go to Egypt with Mary and Jesus because Herod was looking to kill Jesus. That very night, Joseph left for Egypt with Jesus and Mary. They stayed in Egypt until Herod was gone, and it was safe for them to go home to Israel. When they returned, an angel warned them about the new ruler of Judea, who was Herod's son.
This way.
So Joseph and his family went to the region of Galilee and found their new home in the town of Nazareth.
Look good?
Yep.
We'll take it.
Where Jesus would grow up and eventually do all the amazing things God had planned for him to do.
Let's hear it for Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer!
Hey guys, it's me again, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer! And I'm back, and here to win it all! If I had to guess, my favorite part of Christmas is the lights. They're just so pretty! And my favorite thing to do for fun would be going to the movies! I love learning all the quotes from all the movies. And my favorite person is definitely Mr. Rudolph, the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Yep, that's me.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen blitzing, all his reindeer pulling on the reins. Is the bluebird here to stay? Is the new bird? He sings a love song as we go along. Walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no man. But you can do the job when you're in town.
And so this one wasn't a big surprise, but it's still sad to send home Mr. Claus.
Unmasked. Well, I hope that you enjoyed today's show. I think it was one of the best ones yet. Don't forget, send in all your votes. We are counting them today so that you could see who's eliminated next week. And don't forget to stay tuned every single week so that you could find out who's going forward in this competition. I can't wait to see how this ends, and I can't wait to see you next week. Bye.